criteria and SAS criteria, side angle side criteria, and ASA angle side angle criteria, and also congruence of congruence among right angle triangle. Okay, now let's see one by one. The first one is criteria of congruence of triangle. In that, the first one is SSS criteria. Yes, what is this SSS criteria? So it is the, you know that the triangle has three sides, right? So if I give the length of one side, can you able to draw a triangle? No. With the same type, if I give the two sides, the length of two sides they are given, can you able to draw a triangle? No. Let's see here. For example, one of the length they are given 5 cm triangle. So we can draw 5 cm. A line. Okay, and also you may copy the line segment. Okay, so it is 5 cm. Okay, then if they are given another length of the triangle, that is 6 cm, right? So I can draw the angles in the form of right angle, acute angle, and obtuse angle. Okay. It is 6 cm. It is in the obtuse form. It is in the obtuse form. Yes. Can you see here? Is it possible to draw a triangle using the two lengths of the triangle? Right? So we cannot possible to draw a triangle using the two sides of a triangle. So we need three sides of the triangle, that is length of the triangle, right? So we require three sides of triangle to draw a triangle. So we need the third angle, length of the third angle, because all the third line segments or third sides are not equally length. So we need the three sides of the triangle to draw a triangle. To draw a congruent ABC, we need three sides of a triangle. So this is says that the SSS criteria. To draw a corresponding triangle, for the given triangle we need three required measurements. So this criteria is called as side criteria. So what it says that, so if under a given correspondence the three sides of one triangle, the three sides of one triangle are equal to the three corresponding sides of another triangle. Three corresponding sides are on the another triangle, then a triangle of congruent. So what it says that if one of the triangle is corresponds to other triangle, and also the corresponding sides also should be equal in length. For example, you may see here, it is a triangle A, B, C. It is a triangle D, E. D, E, F. Okay, you may observe here, if I overlap these two triangles, we will get match, right? So here, A corresponds to D, and E corresponds to B, and F corresponds to C. The same way, the sides, AB corresponds to DE, and AC corresponds to DF, and BC corresponds to EF. So these two triangles are said to be corresponding triangles. And also we can say that these two corresponding triangles forms the congruents, right? So these are the congruents. So these two triangles ABC and DE here follow the or obey the SSS criteria. Okay, so SSS criteria means the length of three sides are must and should require to draw a corresponding the triangle, then they are said to be congruence. Okay, so it is a SSS criteria. You will see here the vertex, sorry, the side AB measures 5 cm, which is same type ED. So ED measures also 5 cm. Okay, then side FD measures 6 cm. The same type CA measures 6 cm. CA is equals to FD, which is equals to 6 cm. The same type BC and EF are corresponding sides. BC and EF are corresponding sides, which is equals to 7 cm. Then therefore we can say that triangle ABC is congruent to triangle DEF. Clear? So it is clear. So it is the SSS criteria of a triangle. Means if the three sides of the triangle corresponding three sides of one triangle is equal to the corresponding sides of the another triangle is called as the SSS criteria of a triangles. Okay, then let's see here one of the example question is, in a given figure AD is equal to CD. So here AD is equal to CD and AB is equal to BC. AB is equal to BC. Okay, then let's see here, state the three pairs of equal parts in triangle ABD and in the triangle CBD. In the triangle ABD and in the triangle CBD, then is triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CBD. Okay, so then we have to check whether these two triangles are corresponding triangles or not. Okay, and then we have to say reason if there is a corresponding or if it is not corresponding. Okay, then the third one is, does BD bisect and ABC give reason? Okay, so let's see here the first question. State the three pairs of equal parts in the triangle ABD and in the triangle BCD. So you may observe here, in this triangle, the triangle ADB is one of the triangle and the triangle BCB is the other triangle. So in that triangle, you may observe here AB is equals to BC, right? So first one solution, AB is equals to CD and AD is equals to CD. AD is equals to CD. And also we can take the common BD. For both these triangles, BD is common, right? It is common side. Okay, so these are the three parts of the triangle of common or equal in parts. Okay, then let's go to the second one. Is triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CBD? You may check here. So if these two triangles are overlap, you will get the exact copy of the triangle ABD. Hence, you can say that these two triangles are congruent. Okay, then write down here. Second one, yes, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle CBD. So these are congruent triangles. The same way, let's move on to the third one. Does BD bisect angle ABC? Yes. Why? Because BD, yes, is ABC is here. So in that BD bisects the given triangle into two equal parts. So we have to write up yes. Yes. BD bisects. BD bisects is angle ABC. Okay, it is the criteria of SS. Yes. Okay, then let's move on to The second criteria is SAS criteria. The second criteria is SAS comprehensive criteria. So in this criteria we can say that SAS means side angle side. So if you want to draw a triangle, we need two length of sides and one of the measure of angle between that. So then we can draw a copy of a triangle. So here you can see here angle A, L, M is a triangle. To copy this triangle, we require two lengths of the triangle and the angle between that. So here the KM measures 6 cm and LM measures 5.5 cm. And the angle between these two sides is 55 degrees. So with the same time, if we know the two lengths of the triangle and the angle between them, we can easily copy the triangle. Right? So what is the angle? Criteria of SAS congruence. So it says that if under a correspondence two sides and the angle included between them of a triangle are equal to the corresponding sides and corresponding angle included between them of the another triangle, then the triangles are congruent. So we can also check the congruence of triangle using the SAS criteria. If the two sides of a triangle and the angle between them is corresponds to the another triangle having the two sides and the angle between them are equal, then these two triangles are said to be correspondents. Okay, so this is the SAS criteria of a triangle. So let's see here one more example. Here they are given angle ABC and angle DEF. Here the
ED measures 4 cm and in the triangle ABC AC measures 4 cm.
and the angles between two sides. Okay, so